Now we will discuss last article from this topic, that is thermoelectric effect, or called as Seebeck effect. Actually, we have studied that when electric current is flowing in resistance, the energy is supplied there. Electric energy by the battery is supplied there, and it is converted into heat. Scientists Joule have given this equation. The heat created in the resistance is given by I square RT upon J calorie, or it is written as VIT upon J. Okay, so electric energy there is converted into heat. Electric energy is converted into heat. Scientist Seebeck decided to convert heat energy into electric energy, and that's why he has taken two dissimilar metals. See, antimony bismuth, antimony Sb. So this wire is of antimony, and this wire is bismuth, and the two ends are connected. So they form junction. One junction is kept in ice cube, so it is cold junction. Its temperature is 0°C, and second junction is kept in some hot water or hot oil, which is heated. So it is called as hot junction. At that time, he connected the galvanometer between these two, and he found that when two dissimilar metals, two junctions are kept at different temperature, the EMF is induced, EMF is produced in it. Okay, the production of this EMF in the two junctions, when two junctions of two dissimilar metals are kept at different temperature, is called as thermoelectric effect, or it is also called as Seebeck effect. These two metals, these two are called as thermocouple. What it is called as? Thermocouple. The electromotive force, EMF, produced is given by this value, alpha into T. T is the temperature, plus 1/2 alpha T square. Okay, so that is the equation given by Seebeck. And as there is a production of electro EMF in thermocouple, when two junctions are kept at different temperature, there will be current, production of current, DC current. And here, current flows from antimony to bismuth through cold junction. So we will remember this, ABC. Antimony to bismuth at cold junction. So that current will flow in this way, and here in this way. So here at hot junction, bismuth to antimony, and that current will flow in this way, and that's why galvanometer is showing deflection. Okay, so that is one thing. Seebeck have also taken another two dissimilar metals there, ferrous, iron and copper. These two wires are taken. One junction is hot, second junction is cold, and as the two junctions of thermocouple are at different temperature, the EMF is produced. This is called as thermoelectric EMF. Okay, and here EMF produces, and it is written in this way, FCC, ferrous to copper through cold junction. So that is it in this way. Ferrous to copper through cold junction. So this is the thermoelectric EMF produced in the ferrous and copper thermocouple. Here, which pair we have taken? Antimony bismuth. Actually, if we draw for one thermocouple, if we draw the how much EMF is produced and what is the temperature of hot junction, so this is the 0°C, that is cold junction, then graph is in this way. At this temperature, the maximum EMF is produced. Maximum EMF is produced. This temperature is called as neutral temperature. Okay, and this temperature is called as inversion temperature. If we go beyond this temperature, then the direction of that thermoelectric EMF or that current will reverse. Okay, see here, we have taken the equation this, And at this point, what happens? The EMF has maximum value. So there is no any change in EMF. So if we take the derivative of this equation, dE by dt, okay, what will the value? Alpha plus 1/2. Sorry, here beta is there. Beta. And what is the derivative of t square? 2t. Okay, and here there is no change in EMF at this maximum value. At neutral temperature, EMF is maximum value and there is no change. So this is taken as a zero. So what is the value? Alpha plus 2 gets cancelled, beta t. So beta t is equal to alpha and t is equal to alpha upon beta. And this value is called as neutral temperature. Okay, at neutral temperature, what happens? That thermocouple creates maximum EMF, maximum thermoelectric EMF. Okay.